Now it does become more difficult, but all you have to do is press a little bit harder and a little bit harder here. That's where putting it against an object like your chest or your belt buckle or the table when you're loading will really help. I don't like holding it against the table because it's usually too far away from where I'm working. I've got a lot more strength in my fingers when they're right up here in this area versus way out here extended at the end of my reach. So I like to load them right up here or right at my belt. Let's go ahead and move on to another notoriously difficult magazine to load, and that's the Glock 10mm magazine. This is a 15-round magazine, and when you get down to the end of the rounds there, it really gets tight, but I can show you that you can push right through it. So we'll start here on top of the follower, push down and back, down and back, down and back. We got 6 in there, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Now it's real tight. So you really have to push down here. You might have to start by pushing it down like this. So that's kind of a two-step thing. I'm pushing here, I come up with my other finger, push that down a little bit, and then insert that last bullet into the trough, push real hard down, and as you can see, we got it in there. So that's just a real tight fit. Even the 40s are not like that. I don't know if it's just the length of the 10 millimeter that contributes to adding a little bit of friction down in here. But those 14th and 15th rounds can be difficult without a magazine loader. Now I've got a selection of 22 rimfire magazines here. These are 22 long rifle. This is a Browning Challenger. This is a Browning Buckmark magazine. And this here is a Ruger Mark III magazine. They all function about the same way in that they have an assist or a spring assist side knob on them. These are a little bit different. Most of these are going to be a single stack, and all you do is pull down on the spring assist right here, which pulls the follower down. As you can see, the follower goes down and it makes room for a bullet, or I should say it makes room for a round. A bullet isn't the correct terminology. This is actually the bullet, and the entire assembly is the cartridge or round. I have to say that, otherwise somebody will beat me up there in the comments. Pull down on this, it makes room for the next round, and we drop the rim, or the fattest part. This is the rim back here. We drop the rim right into this slot that you see here. Pull this down. Pull this down. And so on. Hopefully that's pretty clear. We'll do a couple more here. And how this looks in practice is something like this. I've got these in my weak hand, the rounds in my strong hand, and I just pull this down, load, 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 load. Load. So, as you can see, the 22 long rifle magazine for most of these is very easy for the pistol. Now, this is a single stack rifle magazine, 22 long rifle. This is a Hot Lips magazine made by Butler Creek, and I found these to be excellent magazines. I've never had a single issue with them, and I own 8 or 10 of them, and I have for many years now. But this does not have an assist or anything to help us pull down on the magazine. So what we're back to again is similar to the pistol magazines. I have to assist or push this down to create a trough right here for the rim of the next bullet to fit into. So I'm just going to kind of stick this against my chest here. I'm going to push this down, and I'm going to push right on top of that next trough and then go backwards with it. Take my next round, push here, push down here, and go backwards with it. Now, because the 22 caliber bullet, the 22 long rifle is so small, my finger is pretty much covering up the process here. But if I do it from the side, you may be able to see that a little bit better. Now, this magazine here is the stock magazine for the 10/22. Now, I just showed you an aftermarket magazine for the 10/22, and this is the original. This is a 10-round rotary magazine. Now, this has a pretty good trough here already, and if you squeeze the rim of this cartridge, this is the rim, if you squeeze that between the existing round that's on top of the lips and this lip right here that I'm tapping on, these will go in very easily. Now, the aftermarket Hot Lips magazine that I showed you is a little bit different and doesn't load as easily as the stock magazine. So these, as you can see, I'm not pressing down with my other index finger. I'm pressing directly onto the cartridge and onto the lips, and it's pushing in that way. So different magazines, different manufacturers will allow you to load a little bit differently, and I tend to just find the most efficient process of doing each one. So, and you will too. It just takes a little bit of time and a little bit of patience for the new shooter. Okay guys, Patriot back again here. We're going to take a look at rifle magazine loading this time. And this is actually very straightforward as compared to pistol magazines. And that is because you can press the round straight down on the follower. So this is going to be pretty condensed. I'll show you three different types here and we'll just kind of speed through them. Okay, I'm going to start off with the AR-15/M16 magazine. And this is just a standard GI magazine. You can see here the follower with a molded shade that helps to correctly position the first round on the magazine so that all the others will stack correctly. And it's also an indicator for the beginner as to which direction the bullet faces that you put down there. And so in this case, it's going to be facing forward like this. And we just set this cartridge, I should say, with the back of the magazine and press straight down. And then we set the next one straight down. Now, you'll notice that I don't have to press backwards like I did with the pistol magazine. I just go straight down. Now, if you start getting fast and you start to go in a hurry like this, sometimes you'll stick one in there a little bit too far forward like this and press down, and you can see how the nose of that bullet is sticking out past here. Well, if I stick the next one up here, it's not gonna go down. Or you may get one down, but you're not gonna get the third one down. See what happens because that bullet's sticking down there? So what we can do is just scooch it back with your thumb. If you go a little bit far like this, just scooch it back. That one's too far too. Just scooch it back. Now, if you line it up right, you don't even have to do that. So if I get five or six of these in my hand, I can move right along. So it doesn't take long to load like that. Let's move on to the FNFAL magazine, or the 308. That takes the 308 or 7.62x51 cartridge, and this is a 20-round magazine. Same thing. Stack the round there in the center and press straight down. And this is kind of a, if you do this with two hands, it goes even faster. This is a long cartridge, so if I press down both front and back like this, it helps it to go straight in without tilting. Lastly, let's look at the AK magazine. Nothing special here again. All we're gonna do is place the round right up top like this and press straight down. Straight down. Get some more ammo. Down, down, down. You can see how easy that is. No special tricks required. No special technique really. Just, you might want to put this up against your chest and press straight down, straight down, straight down, straight down, straight down.
Throw your hands in the air. nice job.